How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to yet another video. And it seems tonight everything is just coming. I mean, just to give you a rough idea, I finished work today about 5:36 p.m. sat in front of my computer around 8 p.m. It's now midnight and I am still recording because the information just hasn't stopped. And if you haven't heard, it does seem like the new information that's just been brought forward about the email that came out from Microsoft HQ from Matt Booty regarding them wanting to buy Activision to put Sony out of business, it's doing the rounds. And as you can imagine, every single Sony fan is jumping on this as a massive victory. And honestly, at this point, I have to ask myself, how dumb are you? I mean, I don't normally take sides in these things, but come on. I mean, this piece of information, and I've seen like massive content creators, or at least they're way bigger than me, right? I'm like the Dreamcast guy, for example. He's going absolutely orgasmic over this piece of information, thinking it's a massive win. But let's just go to the actual tweet itself and we can discuss it, right? But before we do, don't forget to like and subscribe. We're going to hit that 1,000 subs sooner or later. Let's make it sooner. Thanks so much. Don't forget to hit that bell to stay up to date of all content I release. Off we go! So, this is the tweet. This is the one from Steven Totilo. It says, new! Lawyers in the gamer antitrust suit that got thrown out a bunch of times. Yep, I know. I can almost feel your eye rolling at this point. Against the Microsoft Activision deal, have been arguing over Exhibit K, because Exhibit Z is way far away, and well, okay, that joke was really bad. Don't judge me. But why? Because it supposedly shows an Xbox exec saying that the plan around buying Activision is to put PlayStation out of business. Now, this is pretty big news, right? And here's the story. This over here says the court has failed to consider uncontroverted evidence that Microsoft had the intention to put its main competition, the Sony PlayStation, out of the market. And this merger is a part of that strategy. In an internal email, Microsoft's head of Xbox Game Studios stated the following to Microsoft's chief financial officer of Xbox. And essentially it goes along the lines of, we want to put Sony out of business. Right. But let's look at it from an objective point of view. Sony has been paying companies to not release their games on Xbox. Sony has been paying companies to not put games on Game Pass. Sony has been paying companies to make their games exclusive to PlayStation. Sony has been paying companies in regards to crossplay and telling them, well, not paying them, they've been asking companies that if you're going to make your games crossplay and we have to play with Xbox, if they take any of our sales, you have to compensate us with some money for those sales. The weirdest crossplay transactional system I've ever seen. Sony has been basically pulling its weight and telling companies that if you release your game on Xbox, you're not releasing it on PlayStation. Now let that sink in for a second. Does that sound like Sony is supporting Microsoft? It does? Get out. But for those of you that said it doesn't, continue watching. Does it sound like Sony is trying to eradicate Xbox and put them out of business as a console manufacturer? What? Are you saying it does? No. No way. So are you telling me as a business company? So if you owned a greengrocer, for example, right? If you owned a greengrocer and opposite you, there was a business who offered the same products that you did, but was three times bigger. What do you think that they're going to do the first opportunity they get? I'll give you a hint. They're going to put you out of business. Oh, wait, I gave you the answer there. So let me ask you this. Sony has been trying to ruin Xbox and put them out of business for the past 10 years, and they've been doing a fantastic job in that as well. The only saving grace for Xbox right now has been Game Pass. It's literally been the only thing keeping them in. The showcase was fantastic, I'll give them that. But in reality, the only thing that was keeping them in business, in my opinion, isn't the solid output of games, but it was Game Pass. PlayStation did a fantastic job in securing all the cool games, all the best games, and just pumping out quality after quality. When you're looking at games like Final Fantasy VII Remake, Death Stranding, Ghost of Tsushima, these are, you know, AAA, quadruple A games in my opinion. Fantastic games that pretty much move. Just look at Final Fantasy 16. The amount of people who have bought PlayStation 5s. Do you think that Sony didn't put the game on PC day one because they wanted to share their sales with PC? No, they knew that if people wanted to play Final Fantasy 16, the chances of them going to buy a PlayStation was huge. This also puts an actual, you know, dampener on the statement that Phil Spencer said, that if you release an 11 out of 10 game, it won't bring customers. Final Fantasy 16 has proven that to not be the case. If they produce a fantastic game, people will buy an Xbox. In fact, I can say this because someone at my workplace today, talking about Starfield, was so impressed that they actually bought an Xbox just to play Starfield. That's crazy, right? But this is what I'm saying. Big, big games can do that. And this is why Sony deliberately kept PC off Final Fantasy 16 for the time being, for a year, because after a year, no one cares. It's still going to do so well in sales, but it's not going to have the impact it has right now. But this brings me back to the original point. These sorts of emails, which person in any company turns around and goes, hey man, that competitor of mine, I want to send them like a Goodwill basket. I want to share our trade secrets with them. I want to share our profits with them. And I want to make them more profitable than us because we want to support our local competitors. Because we want to make sure that we lose money while they gain money. Yeah, who actually turns around and says that? Like, really, this is literally what they call a nothing burger. They can say what the hell they like in an internal email. It's just jargon. It's just banter. And the way the community is jumping on this is astronomically sad. They are literally gaping at straws. Additionally, it's already been established that in terms of the FTC's case, they don't care about Sony. The SLC for Sony, it's no longer a valid reason. They looked at that, they realized that it's not a defense that they can rely on. And this statement here, even if they turned around and said, we want to put PlayStation out of business. Who doesn't want to put their competitors out of business? It's literally 101 in business. I don't get it. Like, how is this news? Do you think Sony buys all those exclusives because it wants to keep Xbox in business? Is this what people think? Let me know what you think in the comment section below. I did have the NZ video to come out today, but I really wanted to get this one out first because it's literally doing the rounds everywhere right now. It's hilarious. It's absolutely hilarious. And the people that think that this statement, because it is supposedly shows an Xbox exec saying that the plan around buying Activision is to replace it. Well, yeah, my dude, you don't go and spend $70 billion to turn around and say, hey, we're not going to be as competitive, and we're going to make sure we continue to lose money and keep you number one. You spend $70 billion to be more competitive, to have a bigger market share, to fight back. What are these people? I'm sorry to say this, but to the people that are genuinely excited that this is actually something, how do you wake up in the morning? Like, I'm pretty sure that people watching this video, none of you will see this this tweet as anything more than a nothing burger. There is no context even there, and even if there was, literally every company does this. Every company does this. They want to eradicate their competitors so they can take their customers and put it to themselves. That is literally business 101. It's how you grow your business. Do you think Sony wants to lose its player base? Do you think if today, so, you know, Microsoft turned around and said, hey, look, man, we're going to give up. You can take all our complete player base. There's a joke there to be made. I'm not going to go there. You think Sony's going to turn around and go, no, man, no. What you need to do is stay in business, and I'm going to give you like another, 20 million players to come over to your side to support you? Do you think Sony's going to say that? No. Do you think Sony's making Silent Hill exclusive so they can support Sony, Microsoft? Do you think they made Final Fantasy 16 exclusive so they can support Microsoft? Do you think they're making all these games that are coming exclusive? Stellar Blade and everything else. I don't care if they funded it. Do you think they're making it exclusive so they can support Microsoft? No. They're making it exclusive so they can take their player base for themselves. And that results in putting Xbox out of business. Like, I don't know. You let me know in the comment section below what you think. This news is so stupid that I actually had to report on this first, because it is one of the dumbest stories I've seen in a long time. And it actually made me smile and laugh. And it honestly... I can't believe people are looking at this as the gotcha win, as the got him. Are people this delusional? Are people literally this stupid? I mean, just wow, guys. Wow. Anyway, that's it for this video. Let me know what you think, and the NZ one will follow after this one. Promise. Because that's it for me tonight. I'm not making any more videos. Don't forget to like and subscribe. That is free videos. We can get 250 each subs. I know, right? That's a lot. But if we do, that's 750 subs plus the 500. We are done. We have partnered up. Booyah! That's what we need. And then we can make even better content. So hopefully, maybe I'll see it when I wake up. Who knows? Like and subscribe. Hit that bell to subscribe to all content I release. And I'll see you in the next one. We have lots more gaming news coming up as well. We do have some news, I think, tomorrow as well for the ABK. That's going to be streamed. Apparently, the FTC one won't be videoed anymore. Apparently, it was going to be videoed, but now it's not going to be videoed at the request of the FTC, because they don't want to be seen scratching their asses and heads. It's going to have audio only, apparently, so if we can get that, that'll be great, or at least if we can get that for the 22nd, that'll be great. So hopefully we'll get some juicy bits of information that I can pass on to you all. Right, that's it. Remain legend.